Pass me the towel, please.
Sure. Sorry.
Just pretend I'm your sister.
I have two sisters. They don't look like you.
This only works if we both believe it doesn't matter.
Hello there, I'm Bob West, and this is Studio 7 on YouTube West, DTube, and Vimeo. Today I'd like to talk about another sci-fi movie. Yes, we're on a sci-fi roll this week on filming, and we've just done Star Wars The Last Jedi, we did Star Trek 2009, and now you're tuning in going, why are you mentioning that? Dude, those may not even be on your website yet. Oh well. And now I'd like to talk about Red Planet. Now, Red Planet is what we call a core movie. How do I explain this? We're going to have a core group of actors that's very small, very limited. We're going to put them in a bad situation or watch them walk out. That's a core movie. Our background for this is going to be Mars. Now, Red Planet came out at the exact same time Mission to Mars did. A lot of people flocked to Mission to Mars because it had a pretty good cast in it. And you were hopefully not going to be disappointed because it had Gary Sinise in it. And it had Tim Robbins in it. But you were going to be highly disappointed if you went to that and you didn't go see Red Planet. Now, if you saw both, you're going to see the difference immediately. In Mission to Mars, you were entertained. But there was no real substance there. There was no danger there. There was no learning anything there. You could see that plot coming a mile away. But in Red Planet, you have a whole different story. And the reason why is because of the core cast. It's not the spaceship. It's not the planet. It's the group. It's the group that you have in Val Kilmer, Carrie-Anne Moss, Tom Sizemore, Benjamin Bratt, Simon Baker, and Terence Stamp, with music by Graham Revell, which is awesome. The music in this movie is awesome, and it has to be because the music and the lines and the character development and the being of itself is all going to pull this movie together and intertwine it so tightly that you're going to walk through going, man, this is awesome. It's got some of my favorite lines that I love to quote in bad situations. Is this the moment when math saves our lives? I love that line. And it's in here. And it's in here with a bunch of others. But mostly what we have is a good plot. So let me give it to you. We get a spaceship. It's going to Mars. We're going to get to know the crew on the way there. That's not going to take very long. They're going to get there, and they're going to get stuck there, and they're going to have to get off of there. Sounds familiar, like The Martian. Yeah, it does sound familiar, like The Martian, except that this movie was done in 2000, and The Martian was done in 2017 or 16 or whenever it was done, 16 years later. And The Martian's a great book, but in Red Planet, what we get is Val Kilmer actually hitting the pinnacle of his career and his acting. And some people would say, really, dude, you just said Val Kilmer. And I'm going, yeah, I know, the Top Gun dude, right? But when you add Carrie-Anne Moss and Tom Sizemore, you add this kind of special play. Now, Carrie-Anne Moss is three ways to tasty, but she's a good actress. And that's the important thing. And, you know, right now we've got this whole talk about the Me Too movement and the rest of it. And things I got to tell you about actors and actresses is actors stay a long time if they don't take themselves seriously, Jim Carrey. Actresses only stay as long as they're good looking unless they've perfected their craft. And then as the older they get, the less we see of them, Laura Dern, because they're not as good looking. And in Hollywood, for the last 100 years, we have put 40-year-old men with 18-year-old actresses to make all of us guys out here in the real world think we can get the young hotties. It's always been this way. And nobody's noticed it, nobody said anything. Libtards drive me crazy, and liberals drive me crazy in Hollywood because nobody talks about it. There are thousands of movies out there which are what we call close to age relevant, and this is one of them. Our leading man is close to the same age as our leading lady. And Carrie-Anne Moss is going to hit a point in her career, which she did in about 2015. She's just going to kind of drop away and go, that's all right. Cool. You get it. Sandra Bullock learned to act in her craft so that when her cute little high school girl looks went fading away and the ponytails didn't work anymore, she could still work. Hence, The Blind Side. Once people have learned to do this, it becomes apparent in the movies that they do. And in 2000, when this was done, it's the same way. The cast is a core group. It's a believable age group. It has a play on each other.
Commander, a massive low pressure system is approaching the crew. Atmospheric pressure 820 millibars.
Gentlemen, there's an ice storm coming straight for you, and it's big. It's the size of Montana, and it's moving fast. I'm going into calm blackout in a few seconds. You need to find shelter immediately, now.
Where are we going to find shelter around here? Over here! There's an opening!
Maximum sustained winds, 111 miles per hour. Temperature, negative 50 degrees Fahrenheit.
Plot develops and they're going to figure out a way to get back to their spaceship, you're going to see a fantastic group of individuals maneuver their way back and still keep you entertained. And talk about entertainment, there is no more possible group of entertainment than when you have Tom Sizemore at this time, because he's awesome. He's been doing Saving Private Ryan, he's done all of these other movies, and he's just doing it so well. Now, the cinematography is by this guy named Peter Suschitzky. And he brings us those camera angles, those Hitchcockian camera angles, and camera angles like Anthony Mann, depth, shadow, movement. And he still brings it in, even though it's a color movie. It's a Village Roadshow production. It runs about 106 minutes, which is absolutely perfect. And by the time you get done with the story following us on the Red Planet, you're going to say, man, this was awesome. This is the way sci-fi movies should be made, that are non-destructive, that don't have big battle scenes. They have a core group of people. We're interested in them. We want to see how it works. There's the right amount of skin. Everything is set up to make you enjoy an evening watching Val Kilmer, Carrie-Anne Moss, and Tom Sizemore in Red Planet. This movie is a 6 out of 7 production because it got everything right. It did everything right. You may not believe it, but this is a really good movie.